गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन इलेक्ट्रिक एनर्जी। इलेक्ट्रिक एनर्जी वी हैव द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस एज द वी कैन डिफाइन पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस एज द रेशियो बिटवीन इलेक्ट्रिक वर्क डन एंड चार्ज एंड फ्लो थ्रू ए कंडक्टर। ओके, सो ए पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस इक्वल टू वर्क डन बाय चार्ज। वी नो दैट पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस मींस दैट पीडी इज इक्वल टू वर्क डन बाय चार्ज। दैट मींस हियर पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस इज इंडिकेटेड इन रेडियो वेव V equal to WY, you know already. Work done equal to, so potential difference equal to work done by charge. Okay, it is the definition of the potential difference. So, but we know that from this equation we can write here work done equal to V into Q. So we can write here V into Q. So here work done equal to Q into V. That means here potential difference into charge. But here Q equal to from minus I equal to Q by V. We know already. So from this equation we can find here Q equal to here I into T. The place of Q we can write here I into T. So here work done equal to V into I into T. Work done equal to here I into V into T. So here electric energy equal to V into I into T. From Ohm's law. What is Ohm's law? From Ohm's law, we can write here from Ohm's law. So V equal to IR. At the same time, we can write here I equal to V by R. V by R. In the place of I, we can write here V by R. So electrical energy is equal to V into V by R into T. So here V into we can write here V square into T by R. It is the electrical energy equal to V square into T by R. Okay, the same thing we know that here V equal to IR. So from this equation we can write here in the place of V we can write here I square R square into T by R. Here R one we cancel, the remaining value here I square into R into T is also electrical energy. Electrical energy is equal to I square R into T. Okay, these are the formulas to find the electrical energy.
Okay, pleasure once again. potential difference.
The ratio between work product and charge is called potential difference. The ratio between work product and charge is called potential difference. We know that potential difference is indicated with the letter V, and work done is indicated with the W, and the charge is indicated with the Q. Okay, from these equations, V equal to, from this data we can write here, V equal to Q by, sorry, work done by charge, that equal to W by Q. I'm doing cross work here, work done, electrical energy equal to, work done earlier, electrical energy W equal to V into Q, means V means potential difference into charge. So here, from the definition of electric current, so I equal to here, Q by T, I equal to Q by T. So I am doing cross current here, I into T equal to Q. So the place of Q, we can write here I into T. From the above equation, we can write like this, work done or electrical energy equal to V into I into T. So V into I into T. So electrical energy, I V into I into T. From Ohm's law, we know that V equal to I into R. Therefore, I equal to V by R. I equal to V by R. So electrical energy equal to V into I means here V by R. So V by R into T. So V into V, V square into T by R. V square into T by R. Okay. So that equal to V square into T by R equal to electrical energy. But Ohm's law, the place of V, we can write here I R. So what is the value here? V square. The place of V square we can write here I square R square into T by R. So one more get cancelled. Remaining value I square R into T. It is a electrical energy formula. Okay, so already we know the SI unit of energy is joules. So here also we can find the electrical energy in terms of joule. Units. Units for the units of electric energy. Units of electric energy. Units of electric. Units of electric energy. Units of electric energy. The standard unit of electric energy in SI system is joule. The standard unit of electric energy. So here joule means the amount of electric work done when a current of 1 ampere flows through a conductor at a potential difference of 1 volt per 1 second is called a joule. It is defined as the amount of work done. The amount of electric work done. when a current of 1 ampere flows through a conductor at a potential difference of 1 volt per 1 second is called 1 joule. It's called 1 joule.
Listen, it is defined as the amount of electric work done when a current of 1 ampere flows through a conductor at a potential difference of 1 volt for the 1 second is called 1 joule. Standard unit of electric energy in AC system is joule.
Next one, bigger units of electric energy. Bigger units of electric energy. Bigger units of electrical energy. Bigger units of electrical energy. Kilojoule equal to 1000 joules. Megajoule equal to 10^6 joules. Gigajoule equal to 10^9 joules. Bigger units. First one is kilojoule. Simple is K equal to 10^3 joules. Megajoule. Equal to 10^6 joules. Gigajoule equal to 10^9 joules. These are the bigger units of electrical energy. Bigger units of electrical energy. Next one, electric power. Next one is electric power. Electric power. You must have seen written in the bulbs of 60 volts, 220 volts, or 1000 volts to 220 volts. 60 watts to 220 volt or 100 watts to 220 volt. What this marking signify? Well, 220 V means that the bulb will operate when the potential difference in the wire's carrying current is The 60 watt sign means the power of the bulb A 60 watts means the bulb will consume an energy of 60 joules in 1 second. Thus, we can define the power as the rate of doing electric work is called electric power. The rate of doing electric work. The rate of electric work. The rate of electric work. Electric work is called. Generally, you observe the LED bulbs 60 volts or 60 watt, 60 watts, okay, or 60 means 60 volt bulb. 220 volt means the bulb will operate with a potential difference. Generally, we observe this simple sum. Listen, 60 volts, 60 watts. Or 220 volt. Generally, when something is electric bulbs, 60 watts means the power of the bulb. The power comes in 60 watts means the power of the bulb. 60 watts means the bulb will consume an energy of 60 joules in 1 second. 60 watts means. The power of the bulb. The power of the bulb. So it consumes an energy of. It consumes. Consumes an energy of. It consumes an energy of. Energy of 60 joules. 60 joules in 1 second. In 1 second. That is the meaning of 60 watts. So a 220 volt means the bulb will operate when the potential difference in the wires carrying current is 220 watts. So a 220 means the bulb operates. The bulb operate when the potential difference. When the, I am writing here, PD means potential difference in the wire. In the wire carrying current. Carrying current is 220 volt. 220 volt. That is the meaning of 220 volts. Okay. So power means, we know already the rate of doing work is called power. So electric power means the rate of doing electric power means generally below the rate of doing work is called the power. Here electric power, the rate of doing electric work. Electric work is called electric power. Okay, na? We know already the rate of doing work is called power. It is electric power. That means, that's why we can define the electric power as the rate of doing electric work. The rate of doing electric work is called power. The rate of doing electric work is called a power. If W is the work done in time T, such that P is the power. If W is the work done, okay, and T is the time, such that P is the power, such that P is the power. P is the power. P is the power. Then P is the power. Then power equal to work done by time. So here P equal to W by T. P equal to here W by T. Here P equal to W by T. Work done equal P equal to here work done by T. Okay, it is the power. Ready once again, ma. Here P equal to W by T. But we know that work done equal to from the potential difference V equal to here W by Q. From this equation we can write here W equal to V into Q. Now in the place of W here we can write here V into Q. So power equal to V into Q by T. T equal to V into Q by T. Okay, but here charge equal to from the electric current I equal to Q by T. But here what current I equal to Q by T. From this you can write here Q equal to I into T. In the place of Q we can write here I into T. So your power P equal to from here V into I into T by T. That equal to here T get cancelled. Therefore P equal to here PI. P equal to power equal to V into I. From Ohm's law. V equal to IR. V equal to IR. We can find the I value equal to V by R. V by R. Therefore power P equal to VI. But here I means here V by R. So P equal to V into V by R. That is E. Therefore P equal to V into V. V square by R. V square by R. V square by R. V square by R. From this we can write here R. P equal to V into I. From Ohm's law we can write here V equal to IR. So here P equal to the place of V we can write I into R. So I into R. So here in the place of V we can write here I into R. I into R that equal to I square into R, that is P. So power equal to power P equal to I square into R. Okay, once observe. Listen once again, ma. Power means the rate of going electric work is called power, electric power. Power equal to, we know that work done by time. So P equal to W by T. But potential difference is equal to work done by charge. From this equation you can find work done. Work done equal to potential difference into charge. In the place of W we can write here V into Q.
So therefore power equal to V into Q by 10. But electric current I equal to Q by T. From this equation we can find Q value. Q equal to I into T. So P equal to V into Q by T. From this equation, in the place of Q we can write I into T. I into T. Therefore P equal to V into I into T by T. So here T get cancelled. What is the remaining value? P equal to V into I. From Ohm's law, V equal to IR. V equal to IR. From this equations we can find I value. I equal to V by R. V by R. In the place of I we can write V by R. So power P equal to V into I. So P equal to V into by R. So V into V equal to V square by R. So from the above equation, P equal to V into I. From Ohm's law, in the place of V, we can write IR. So P equal to V into I. So here V means I into R. So P equal to I into R. That equal to I square into R. Power equal to I square into R. It is the equation for the electric power. Now I will write units for the electric power. Units of electric power. So units of electric power. The SI unit of power is what? The SI unit of power is what? R. Joule per second. R joule per second. So 1 kilowatt equal to 1000 watts. 1 megawatt equal to bigger units of power. Bigger units of power. Bigger units of power. So here kilowatt. What equal to 10 power 3 watts? Megawatt equal to 10 power 6 watts. Gigawatt equal to 10 power 9 watts. These are the units of electric power. Okay. Tomorrow I will explain problems based on the electric energy and the electric power. Okay. Thank you.